On board the Jolly Oak, Captain Gold McCall is playing chess with his treasure pieces against his parrot, Flaviu Feathers. Flaviu Feathers is winning wings down, and Captain Gold McCall is sulking badly. As he throws his pieces overboard, he spies a boy stranded on a desert island, waving palm leaves to attract people's attention.
Ahoy, ahoy, a sea boy! Hey, that rhymes! Crew, you heard the captain said the sailors must head to the island.
The crew busy themselves on board the boat.
Does he wash up? Never wash up. Does he clean up? No, he never cleans up. Does he brush up? Never brushed up. He does nothing. The boy does nothing.
Skull, that's me. We're the best pirate the sea has ever seen. We are brave and tough and super mean.
Of course, here we are strong, mighty, clever, and full of wit.
Me, Bones, and we're the best youngest guy I can live.
Ouch!
What are you three up to? Double quick, we need to guide that way!
Meanwhile, on the island, a young boy called Boris is waving frantically with his palm leaves, jumping up and down with his new magic monkey friends.
Wicked, wicked, jungle is massive. Wicked, wicked, jungle is massive. Wicked, wicked, jungle is massive.
Go to work, don't go to work. Stay at home, don't stay at home. I should have stayed at home and not traveled to my holiday destination. Stuck, now I am stuck. Who will save me? Oh look, a boat!
Ooh ee ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bang bang. Ooh ee ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bang bang.
That's right, Jokey Johnson, a boat! We are saved! Now stand 2 meters away from the shore, ready to greet our rescuers and get the key for number 10 out of the suitcase.
The Jolly Oak arrives on shore, and as Boris pulls out the key, Captain McCall spies it through his telescope.
Skull, Frost, Bones, fetch me my map from my cabin. Hurry up! Lazy Bones.
You got it back to front.
Shiver me timbers, that boy has found the key to secret treasure on Corona Island. I need that key. Give me the key. Tea? I don't have any tea!
That boy defies me and mocks me. Of course he has a key. Flabby fellas, fetch me that key!
Aye, Captain. I wonder, Jokey Johnson, why he wants tea. It must be dirty work being a pirate. Water, water everywhere and not a drop to drink.
Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bing bang.
That's right, Jokey Johnson. We could indeed go into the forest and fetch him a nice coconut smoothie instead. Lead the way.
Boris and his trusted friends walk off in search of coconuts and light refreshments, while Captain McCall looks on puzzled.
Where's he going?
Here. You got it the wrong way around.
Stop it, you two scallywags, I'm trying to concentrate here.
Why are you still looking through your telescope, Captain? We're already ashore. I thought I was meant to lead the land, lover.
I knew that! Right, man. Avast me hearties. Anchorage, furlough, all that stuff pirates say. Let's find that key!
The crew make their way off the Jolly Oak and down the hot sands into the forest in search of Boris, Jokey, Johnson and the key.
Jokey, Johnson, what do coconuts actually look like? Do you know, chaps?
Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bing bang.
Yes, really, we don't actually get many palm trees of Westminster.
Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bing bang.
They're bright brown and hairy, you say. Didn't we see something like that on the way to the forest?
Boris looks around and spots what he thinks looks big, brown and hairy, and suddenly gets the shock of his life.
Here we are! Bob Laundry, what is that? I need to wash my hands.
Meanwhile,
I found the suitcase, but no key, Captain.
What do you mean, no key?
Oh, that's my line, you landlubber.
Oh, by the way, I saw a boat heading towards the forest, holding something shiny.
You couldn't have gone far.
Do you think this weird print thingy shaped like feet might be a clue?
Oh, well, bless my barnacles, they are indeed. Follow this footprint!
The captain and his crew venture deep into the forest in search of Boris, Jokey, Johnson, and the key.
Well, Jokey, Johnson, I believe you are lost. I feel as if we'd be going round and round in circles, and I've nothing to show for it.
Ooh, ee, ooh, ah, ah, ting, tang, walla, walla, bing, bang.
I wonder where our guests have got to.
Through the rustling leaves, Captain Gold McCall and the crew bravely, or not so bravely, appear.
At last we meet.
I say, there you are, welcome. But please remain at a 2 meter distance. Or is it 1 meter plus?
The key, hand it over.
What, this? Why do you need my house key?
He's tricking you, Captain. Don't fall for his propaganda.
As per usual, I am thoroughly confused. What is going on?
You hold the key to the treasure of Corona Island.
Aye! Well, in that case, here you go. On one condition, you take me back to 10 Downing Street.
Whatever.
We need to go to the cave that says X marks the spot.
That cave? That's where old Captain Chaucer gets guarding a treasure box.
¿Qué? ¿Por qué no le dijiste antes?
What?
Ooh, ee, ooh, ah, ah, ting, tang, walla, walla, bing, bang.
Lead the way.
Certainly, sir, on one condition.
Oh, stop with your silly conditions.
Boris, now the leader of the party, heads into the cave and straight into Captain Short Circuits, who's trying out the new Year 7 science curriculum.
Box and cables, who goes there?
Don't you know who we are?
We're the tremendous trio. Skull.
Bones.
I'm Captain Gold McCall, the mightiest of them all. Oh, that rhymes again?
Flap your feathers, flap your feathers.
Excuse me, young chap. We have all voted to leave the island and have come here to negotiate a deal.
A deal? It's like a light bulb just gone off my head. After 12 weeks of self-isolating myself in my cave, I'm rather lonely.
Ting tang, walla walla bing bang.
That's right, Jokey. Johnson, what a brilliant idea. Jokey and Johnson will stay here with you in exchange for the treasure.
Oh my goodness!
A rapturous applause and squawks of delight echo around the cave. Graciously, Captain Gold McCall collects the treasure.
Why do we rid him?
That's right, Jokey, Johnson. Wait, hang on a minute. My time on Corona Island has been a great adventure. Hey, Fever, what a team we make.
Yes, what a team. Now go wash your hands.
Next stop, High School Island.
New beginnings.
So no one told you that before.
Has got the ball.
You got this, Darius.
No, you don't.
Go, Darius. Go, Darius. Go, Darius.
I'm going to not make you Neymar.
Now for you, Ronaldo.
I mean, like, you could try if you want.
Wow, it seems like Darius has met with some of the best players in the world. This could be a mess. This could be amazing. Darius has gotten the ball into the area and he shoots. He scores. Darius has only gone and done it. He's won the Premier League for Oak Ridge School.
I knew you could do this, Darius.
Busy day today. Here's a lady who definitely needs a haircut.
Mr. Nutby, you haven't changed, but your hair has.
Are you gonna cut my hair or not?
I'm so sorry, have a seat. So, what would you like me to do with your hair today?
I want a complete new look.
Actually, we have a new customer.
I like my hair. I rate this salon a 5-star.
Whoa, the last time I saw you, you were way taller than me.
Well, I'm not wearing my heels today. What have you done to my hair?
I love it.
I'm glad you like it.
Thank you for coming. but I followed my dreams and here I am today.
And for the most prestigious award, the Oscar Award, Actress of the Year goes to...
I'm amazing. So I would like to say thank you to the people that helped me get where I'm today. So thank you to my mom, to my dad, to my sisters, to my bestie, to my dad's uncle's stepsister's daughter, to my dead cat, may she rest in peace, to the dog that ran away.
And thank you very much.
Finished? As I was saying, to the dog that ran away, and most importantly, to Faith. Oh, and my driver, because I couldn't actually be here without my driver, so thank you.
It's so unfair.
The Fun Bubble presents Adventures of the Spice from the Future.
This is a tale of two spies from 2050 who go back in time on a daring adventure to save a dear friend. We hope you enjoy it.
Carl, are you okay?
I'm fine.
Hold on, stay with us.
You have been my best friend, guys.
The spacer. He's dead.
No.
Jenny was upset and Connor was mad because Carl died of an infection he caught in his lungs from a fire when he was a baby. They both decided to get into their time machine and go back in time to stop the fire.
Time to go to
2020! Yeah!
2020! I knew that.
Put the box in the safety seat.
How long is it going to take?
An hour?
You what?
I'm joking, only 5 minutes.
Phew.
What the heck? This is too bumpy.
Jenny and Connor arrive at Carl's apartment in the post.
This is the place.
Yeah, let's head in and save Carl.
Connor and Jenny run as quick as they can to save the baby.
Jenny's the baby Carly. I'll go get him, okay? Go see if anyone else is on the third floor.
Okay.
Connor sees a mysterious woman with a sneaky look.
I'm the one who burned down this building. Mwahaha!
No way.
What happened? Go get safety. Don't worry about me.
Will they escape?
As they have encountered the evil Madam Overlord, they prepare for an epic battle.
Prepare to lose.
You wish, henchmen!
Jenny, go off.
Okay, be safe.
Reporting to duty, ma'am.
I think we're late.
Of course we are. I'll be quiet. Why are they in hiding first?
Why are they in hiding first?
After an epic battle face to face with Madam Overlord, a great explosion occurs. Wildly Jenny checks on Connor. Is Connor alive? And how can a baby talk?
Connor! Connor, wake up! Connor!
As Jenny starts to give up and walks away, she hears movement beneath the rocks. Her first assumption was that Connor was dead. Let's just say she was wrong.
Connor?
Connor! Jenny realized who it is. Of
before she could do anything, ran over and slapped her. She places the baby down on Connor and slaps her back. The shop ran over and her husband ran away.
I'll get you back, you pesky spies! Yeah!
Connor, get out and stop for you, lady!
What did he just say?
Goo goo gaga!
Are you alright, Connor?
Yeah, I'm fine. Let's just get the baby out as well.
They return the baby to his mother and they go back home safely in the time machine.
Gotta go back. 2050.
Yeah, that was a big adventure. I'm excited to meet Carl again.
Yeah, I need to remember that, huh?
The end.
Death of Iola, the Olympics has been delayed until the detectives discover who murdered her. Melissa, Alexandra and Temis are at the scene of the murder.
Everyone split up and look for clues. Let's all split up and look for clues for the death of Iola that will be in the news. You're wasting our time.
I sure about that.
Look! I found something. There's a bow on the sea
which looks like
yes.
Look, it has a logo engraved on it. This shows the shop. This shows the place where the bow was bought.
Well, you two people are really useful after all.
I don't know if I should take this one or not.
Well, you two people is the only one you're getting. Let's go to the shop.
I found this bow, which seems to have come from your shop. Take it.
Ah, yes, one of my finer pieces. So, how can I help you?
Aunt, so that's what we need.
Who bought it for me, too? I'm not sure she was
hearing this.
Excuse me, I could shut down your business.
Oh, no, don't do that, a man came in last week, his name was Matthias. He came in and bought it.
Do you have anything to eat? I'm really hungry. Let's go to Burger King.
That's not important right now, people. We need the address.
What are you guys, like stalkers?
Only in my free time. This is one.
Okay, right then, I'll tell you. It's 27 Oakridge Road, Hotel Papa, 11 2 Papa, November.
Pleasure to meet you, Theodore, Papa Papas.
And to you, enjoy the rest of your day.
Yeah, bye.
Yeah, but it's not for you.
Thomas, you need to get a choice of it. You can get food later, alright? But Thomas, we're here to ask them questions.
Okay, what about?
Where were you in the morning of today?
I was here cooking burgers.
Ooh.
They're for me, not for you.
Cameron, just stop talking about food for 1 second.
One.
But Thomas, we found a bird at Olympic this morning and Theodora said that you bought it.
Why is that important?
Someone's murdered this morning, and at the moment, you're the prime suspect.
What are you talking about? I've been here all morning, chilling, making food. That's the boy I bought for my cousin.
Well, now we know he's innocent.
I don't know.
I know. And that's his.
What do you mean?
What's that?
I know.
Exactly. What do you? You know.
I know.
Sir?
$30,000
No way.
Okay, you're not going to get any info.
5,000
20
15
18,000 rubles. Take it or leave it.
It's a deal, I guess.
Fine, this morning I was watching the race and I saw which direction the arrow came from.
That is so not worth 18,000 V-Bucks, mate.
Wait, I'll show you exactly which lane it was pointed to. It was Dinosaur's lane.
That's very valuable information.
Dead on the floor. Dennis had killed him.
Alyssa, what have you done? I gave you the bow for archery practice.
He killed my brother. I knew no one would believe me, so I had to kill myself in revenge. But it all went horribly wrong. Ayola's dead, and it's me that killed her.
But why did Dan want to kill your brother in the first place?
My brother was always the best runner in
the school. I found you! Now give me my blue box!
Like I said, my brother was always the best runner in the quiz, but Thanos was always jealous of him.
Even if you did want revenge, murder is not the solution.
I realise that now, but I can't change the past.
Lisa got the rope.
The detectives went to Thanos' house and arrested him for the murder of Achilles. Thanos was put in jail for 25 years and Alessa was sentenced to 15 years.
I can't believe I'm in jail. All of this for me being in jail? Oh, I shouldn't have listened to Titus in the first place. Titus, thanks.
I bless the light that lights on you.